Live from Augustana Lutheran Church, it's Christmas Eve. Welcome to worship.
The stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul felt its worth. A thrill of hope the weary world rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. When Christ was born, oh, night divine, oh, night, oh, night divine. Truly he taught us to love one. His law is love, and his gospel is peace. Chains shall he break, for the slave is our brother, and in his name all oppression shall cease. Sweet hymns of joy in grateful chorus raise we, let all within us praise his glorious name. Christ is the Lord. Oh, praise name forever. His power and glory evermore proclaim. His power and glory.
John. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him not one thing came into being. What has come into being with him was life, and the light was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it.
He was in the world, and the world came into being through him. Yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who did receive him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood or of the will of the flesh or of the will of man, but of God.
And the Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth.
And from his fullness we have all received grace upon grace.
Please rise, Mr. Raple.
Seat, this great holy land.
Yes. Go ahead. Augustana and friends, you're back. After the pandemic, you know, got a little sparse and it built up and built up, and now we're overflowing again. And we'll have three services next year to keep on building back strong. But we want to make sure if you need seats, there are seats right up front. If you came late, you get to be right where all the good things are happening. So welcome to all of you as we gather on this Christmas Eve. As other parts of the world, it's already Christmas Day. Many places of the world we lift up in prayer tonight. But welcome to Augustana. We're a thriving, multicultural, multinational, multigenerational congregation called by Christ to work with our siblings, Native American spiritual leaders, Muslim, Jew, Hindu, Buddhist, Sikh, other people of faith, and people of just goodwill, to weave the beloved community where everyone is welcomed and affirmed for who God created you to be. And that's all of yourself, your ethnicity, your age, where you were born, your sexual orientation, your non-binary status, your gender expansiveness. However you define how God made you is pure gift to this community, this city, this world in which we live. As we leave here tonight, I hope we continue to take that with us to weave the beloved community where justice and peace kiss. We're a solar sanctuary church, which means we get our power from the sun, S-O-N and S-U-N, so all the lights are from the sunshine. But as a sanctuary church, this church is a place of safety for immigrants and other people who are looking for safety until the world is what God intended it to be a sanctuary for all of us. So welcome to worship. We're going to sing like always, and have a great time tonight. Let us continue with the litany. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light.
The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it.
The Word became flesh and dwelt among us. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given.
In him was life, and the life was the light of all people.
Please join us in the Christmas prayer. Almighty God, you made this holy night shine, the brightness of true light. Grant that here on earth we may walk in the light of Jesus' presence, and in the last day wake in the brightness of his glory. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated.
Two. Isaiah 9, verses 2 through 7. The people that walked in darkness have seen a great light. They that dwell in the land of the shadow of death, upon them hath the light shined. Thou hast multiplied the nation and increased its joy, the joy before thee according to the joy in harvest, as people rejoice when they divide the spoil. For thou hast broken the yoke of their burden and the staff of their shoulder, the rest of the oppressor, as in the day of the Midian. For every battle of the warrior with confused noise and garments rolled in blood, but this shall be with burning and fuel of fire. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace there shall be no end upon the throne of David and upon his kingdom to order it and to establish it with judgment and with justice from henceforth, even forever. The zeal of the Lord of the hosts will perform this. The word of the Lord.
Time we'd invite children to come up. And Kenny Shields, are you back there? Kenny? And the drum. Can he come in right now, or is he? Come on. I'll tell you what, children, we're going to sit and have another reading, and we'll do the children's time after the next reading, okay?
I'm not sure how we do this, Marilyn. We'll make it work. But we do want the drum in. So come on up, all of you. Come on up. And have a seat, okay? Good to see all of you. We have a special drumming we're going to do. Some of our Native American members, and they're going to do a drum to, celebration for Jesus' birth, which is very special tonight. There's a village in Portland called Barbie's Village. It's off 33rd and Sandy by the Presbyterian Church there. And Barbie was a member of this church, and her husband is Kenny, so Barbie and Ken. And they always played with that name, and they have three children. But Barbie died too young, but she always wanted people to have housing. And so her story inspired a lot of people of faith and goodwill to work together to create housing for people who need it on 33rd, and it's called Barbie's Village. But Kenny, who's going to play in a moment, I think he had to bring his kids in, is her husband, and he's worked hard at it. And he works very hard to make sure his kids get to thrive like all of you. Why don't you do me a favor? Go ahead and sit down. Go ahead and sit for a moment. And Marilyn, if you would do Sweet Little Jesus Boy now, please.
Jesus boy, they made you be born in a manger. Sweet little holy child, and we didn't know who you were. You'd come to save us, Lord, to take our sins away. Our eyes was blind, we could not see, and we didn't know who. The world treats you mean, Lord. Well, they treat me mean too. Oh, but that's how things is down here. And we didn't know it was you. You done told us how, and we trying, Master, Lord, you done showed us how. Even when you was dying, like we can't do right. Look how we treated you. But please, sir, forgive us, Lord. We didn't even know it sweet little Jesus boy, born such a long time ago.
Marilyn, thank you. And to the children, whose birthday we're going to celebrate tomorrow? What's the answer? Whose birthday? I know you know. Jesus, of course. That's the best answer. And I hope you all have an incredible night tonight. I'm so glad you started it by coming to church tonight. And have a great day tomorrow with your families, okay? Now, all over the world, people are celebrating the birth of Christ. In every language, in every tongue. And we have many tribal nations representing this church. And so tonight we're going to have a song led by some of our members in tribute. So I want you to come down to another place. And I'm sure the 1-year-old is going to love this. So come on, let's come down by the drummers, by Kenny and everybody, and hear the honor song for Jesus.
Oh, you.
Now, children, that's a great way to start Christmas, isn't it? So, have a great worship, everybody. Thank you. All right.
So our second reading, our next reading after that beautifulness is from Luke chapter 2, verses 1 through 7. And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. I agree. And this taxing was first made when Cyrenius was governor of Syria. And all went to be taxed, everyone into their own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
A reading from Luke, the second chapter. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you, ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward all. And it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, Let us now go even unto Bethlehem and see this thing which is come to pass, which the Lord hath made known unto us. And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. And when they had seen it, they made known abroad the saying which was told to them concerning this child. And all they that heard it wondered at those things which were told them by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. And the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, as it was told unto them. The word of the Lord. Please rise as you are able for the next song.
Thank you.
Thank Kenny and those who drummed tonight. His three-year-old wanted to drum more. We love that spirit. And we want to thank our Augustana Jazz Quartet. They're all in town. Not always the case. They're all wanted around the world for great music. Ron Steen, drums. Kevin Dietz, bass. George Mitchell, piano. Marilyn Keller, vocals. I'm supposed to have this service completed by 8:15, we'll see. But as the preacher, I can always edit back, but the stories are so good. You know, you can all relax now, exhale. Everything's closed, there's nothing more you can do. Just cheer on and give thanks for all those who work night shifts in this city for so many different reasons, caring for people. And care for one another. That's what Christmas and the birth of Christ is about, seeing the divine and what God has done for us and seeing each other in like minds. There's a lot of good stories that go around this time of year. I always loved Christmas. We have new parents in the church. One of our mothers, Rachel, whose son will be baptized in the new year, posted a cartoon in the office the other day. It said, after the wise men left, Mary and Joseph and the baby Jesus, the wise women came. They brought fresh diapers, casseroles for the week, and some good wine. There's a story the other day about a hospital back east where the staff and the community go all out to make sure all the children that are in that hospital over Christmas can have a Christmas tree in their room, so they take one floor and get all these trees put together by the community. And they followed a little girl and a little boy as they got to choose what tree they wanted. The little guy wanted the Hot Wheels tree. And when it came to his room, he just shouted out, "I love it." That's what Christmas is all about. A time to love each other in new ways, not just here, but around this globe. Turn to your neighbor and say, "You are beautifully made." And turn to another neighbor, whether you know them or not, and say, "Aren't you lovely?" All right. Oh. Let us pray. Gracious and loving God, on this Christmas Eve, as we celebrate the Word made flesh, dwelling among us with grace and truth, make us instruments of your peace. Where there is hatred, let us sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is discord, union. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. Where there is sadness, joy. Grant that we may not so much seek to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love. For it is in giving that we receive, it is in pardoning that we are pardoned, it is in dying that we are born to eternal life. Amen. A poet once wrote these words: "Hush, all ye sounds of war. Ye nations, all be still. A voice of heavenly joy steals over vale and hill. Oh, hear the angels sing the captive world's release. This day is born in Bethlehem the Prince of Peace. No more divided be, ye family of human beings. Old enmity forget, old and new friendships knit again. In the new year of God, let siblings' love increase. This day is born in Bethlehem the Prince of Peace." I went to the Holy Land the week after Katrina. It was a trip with Muslim, Jew, and Christian leaders, 15 of us around the country in the Christian community, Jewish leaders, and Muslim leaders. It was 2 weeks after Gaza had been returned to the Palestinians. I'll never forget meeting in Jerusalem with the Interfaith Council of Jerusalem. I didn't realize it existed. Muslim, Jew, Christian. Other places we met. And underneath the leadership was a hope among the peoples to weave community, to work together. The Church of the Nativity in Bethlehem said they've canceled Christmas Eve tonight as we think of what's taking place in Gaza, as we pray for Israeli families and Jewish families who are living in fear, as we see a strip of land decimated along the coast in Gaza, families with absolutely nothing. It's hard to imagine in a country where we panicked for toilet paper during the pandemic, to think of what people are dealing with. It would be easy to ignore, but as people of faith, our call is to weave and to work, that the nations will not rage anymore, that our country would stop being the producer of the most arms in the world, that Isaiah reading talks about the warriors' battlements being trampled upon and burned, that peace may come. We are all connected tonight. And so tonight we stand with our Muslim and Jewish and Christian siblings. We stand against Islamophobia, anti-Semitism. We work to transform hearts and lives. Christmas is about having hope in the midst of bleakness sometimes, oftentimes. Some of you have lost people in your family this past year, and you've been through some hard times. Some of you are going through things yourselves. And to find those places of hope where you can move forward into the future, seeing possibility, a future of promise, Christmas is about that. The birth of Christ, that God would love us so much that the God of creation would become one of us. It doesn't matter what Jesus looked like. It doesn't matter what his, I said about who we are in this church, they could be, Jesus could come with any one of us in that shape, form, or color. The key is, it was Christ coming to us in the flesh to show God's love for us. And then to call us to love one another like never before. In this nation tonight, we have to stand up and say enough. As Gandhi once said, an eye for an eye, we'll all be blind. When women's reproductive rights are being threatened around this country, when immigrants are being closed off at a border with hate rather than being welcomed with love, when white supremacy and racism that have threatened BIPOC communities for hundreds of years is on the rise, when anti-Semitism, Islamophobia is out there, threats against the LGBTQ community, the creation which has been growing under the pressure of a consumptive world economy, schools where gun violence is on everyone's mind, houselessness in this country, it could be easy to come together tonight and say, oh, can't deal with it. And yet here we are gathered tonight with the spirit of hope and joy and love to hear in just 20 lines from the Gospel of Luke, one of the most beautiful stories of God coming into our midst to renew us, to love us, Emmanuel, God with us. We are here while Caesar slept. We are here for the birth of a child in a very desperate situation like many children tonight. We are here to see humble and outcast shepherds, the one who the angels came to make the announcement to. And you know what those angels said that night? Go to those hills of Bethlehem. Many of you have stood on those hills. And you know those words. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly hosts praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest, and peace, goodwill to all. Just for a few more minutes, since I'm the one that's got to keep the time, just a few more minutes, let's reflect on the theme, goodwill toward all. Does the world need people going out of churches, synagogues, mosques, temples, longhouses saying, I'm going out to work for goodwill for all? Does the world need that tonight? I know you know that. I know the answer before I ask the question, but goodwill toward all the angels saying this birth of Christ in a manger was that we might know God's love, but we might share it then with every sinew of our body. And tonight, more than ever, we must be about that. A famous cellist was being interviewed not long ago You know, you have the pastors, you got to drive places. Somebody's sick or ill or something's going on and you get in the car. So I listen to, you know, NPR or something like that. And Cellos was being interviewed and talked about when their son was born prematurely in an incubator. And this cellist took his cello into this ward with all these babies, newborns, that were in tough situations and just started to play the cello. And mothers and fathers started to smile as they held those babies. And they could feel that healing power. That's what tonight's about. Hopefully you come into this house of prayer for all people tonight. You feel surrounded by love and candlelight and great music to have ourselves renewed for the days ahead. Tonight, more than ever, we need to be able to share the story of a God who is a God of love. Jesus, born again while emperors slept, who had had poor people travel miles to go get taxed, while there was no room for them in the inn. We think of places where there's no place tonight for people. A baby being born, in just one sentence it says that. And then the angels, who do they go to see? The shepherds on the hillside, the ones who are the outcasts of society, they heard the good news. And when they heard, what did they do? They ran into Bethlehem with their sheep. Oh, that must have been quite a sight, all looking for this manger. And then they gathered, and there they heard Mary and Joseph, these proud parents, and it says they couldn't stay. They had to go out and tell everybody. While Mary pondered all these things in her heart. My siblings in Christ, tonight is a night for us to do the same. But look at the world tonight, pray for all the places of conflict, and then to work to weave community. Look around tonight. You're with a lot of people, some you know, and a lot of people you don't know. That's the kind of God we have that brings us together to work together. Well, as the angels sang goodwill toward all, that is what we are called to be about tonight. In a manger where nobody expected us, what is God doing tonight in places nobody would ever expect something to come from? Every time we do justice work in this church with our siblings and other denominations and faith communities and good people of goodwill, we talk about never underestimate what God is doing in a basement of a church or a synagogue or a mosque or in a longhouse. You never know what's taking place that may lead to good. God is doing something new. I heard the other day that the most popular Christmas song is Jingle Bell Rock by Blake Shelton. Now, I would have taken Do You Know What I Know by Whitney Houston. But I have to differ with those polls on the most popular songs around. I think they're Christmas carols, the gospel carols and the classical carols, the drum carols and the played carols. People are singing, they want to sing songs of hope. And if you look at the sounds, the words of many of these songs we sing, they are powerful words about a Prince of Peace, about a new way of living, about hope. Handel's Messiah, oh, and go listen to Quincy Jones's version as well. It's awesome. For unto us a child is born to sing, unto us the son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder. And then it goes in that crescendo, his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Oh, the favorite carols, I think, is what we sing. When I watch you sing tonight, I wish I could stand here and watch you sing. I love to see faces singing. And we had that experience the last few weeks. We had the Beaumont Middle School Choir here. We had our own choir do a concert. We had Grant High School Choir. We were packed every night for the last 2 weeks. And then we had Inmedale, which is a new choir that started here, about 35 young adults. If you get a chance, come to their concert in the spring. Brilliant. But what they did at the end of their concert is they surrounded all 500 of us who were here that night, and they led everybody in carols. And I sat right up where you're sitting, Kenny, because I want to look back and see everybody. People sang. Timber's Nation has nothing on us in singing. People sang. They wanted to sing the carols because it fills your heart with joy. Oh, I can't help but think if we're going to go goodwill towards all, we need to sing together more. We need to celebrate each other more. We have to say to each other, you are beautifully made. That's part of living. Find a stranger on the bus tomorrow or wherever you go on your Uber. I don't care where you are. Tell people they're beautiful. They don't hear that very often. But Christmas is a time when Jesus came as a child of God to be among us, to show us how to love, to show us how to give, to show us how to weave the beloved community. So angels, we have heard on high, we sing. Oh, you can't beat that. The first Noel, the angels did sing to certain poor shepherds. Oh, you know, just start working those, the first Noel. Oh, little town of Bethlehem, how still we see thee lie. Joy to the world, the Lord has come. Young people, look at the hymns, because all these hymns, it says, let heaven and nature sing. We want to save the earth, don't we? We got work to do. Our hymns speak about saving the earth. They speak about peace among nations. That is part of who we are. Oh, I love our young leaders today. We are so blessed in this community to have our elders and the wisdom to have the passion of the young. Let us go forth today, not putting our head down and saying, the world's too messed up, I can't do anything about it. I'm coming out of church. I'm coming out of Christmas Eve. I'm coming out hearing the Word made flesh full of truth and life. I'm hearing about, I need to go tell it on a mountain, you guys. Well, let's take the drums, let's go tell everybody. Jesus Christ is born. Oh, Marilyn, get ready to lead us. We're ready to sing. I think I'm just going to stand up here and watch everybody singing tonight because it's so exciting to see you all. Turn to your neighbor one more time and say, you are wonderfully made. And then say, and we love you. All right, let's sing. Stand and sing with Marilyn. It's Christmas Eve. Let's run with this. We got work to do. Let's go, Marilyn.
Tell it on the mountains, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. While shepherds kept their watching o'er silent flocks by night, behold, throughout the heavens there shone a holy light. Tell it on the mountains, over the hills. Tell it everywhere, go, go. Tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. The shepherds feared and trembled when low above the earth rang out the angel chorus that hailed our Savior's birth. Everybody ought to go. Tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that my Jesus Christ is born. Down in a lonely manger, the humble Christ was born. And God sent us salvation that blessed Christmas morn. Everybody ought to go tell it on the mountains, over the hills. Tell it everywhere you ought to go. Tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is. Oh, go. Tell it on the mountains, over the hills. Tell it everywhere. Go. Tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born.
Go ahead and be seated. This time our young leader will take the offering tonight. As you offer your gifts, the work of this congregation through all of you is vital in this community, in this world in which we live. So give as you are able, but always be generous because we have many things we are about together. I do want to say in this congregation, we give scholarships to all 22 of our college students, as well as we have some of our students who are in prison and some who serve in the military, and everybody gets a scholarship. And we also lift up those who are houseless in this city, working with others. May God bless you as you give tonight, and those assisting with communion, if you would please come forward as you are able. And I do apologize, we're short a few bulletins. I think I asked for 500. Usually I overestimate, but we used them all up, so that's wonderful to see. So those serving communion, I think the running family is going to assist tonight, and some others. Thank you. And if anybody needs a candle for Silent Night, raise your hands and the ushers will make sure you get one. As the offering comes forward, let us rise as you are able. And let us pray. God of all creation, all you have made is good, and your love endures forever. You bring forth bread from the earth and fruit from the vine. Nourish us and all creation with these gifts, that we might be for the world signs of your gracious presence in Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ. In the wonder and the mystery of the Word made flesh, you have opened the eyes of faith to a new and radiant vision of your glory, that beholding the God made visible, we may be drawn to the love of God whom we cannot see. And so with the choirs of angels this night, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Holy, mighty, and merciful Lord, heaven and earth are full of your glory. In great love you sent to us Jesus, your Son, who reached out to heal the sick and the suffering, who worked to renew the earth, who welcomed the stranger, embraced the child, freed the oppressed, who preached good news to the poor, and who on the cross opened his arms to all. In the night in which he's betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks and broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this for the remembrance of me." Remembering, therefore, his death, resurrection, ascension, we await his coming in glory. Pour out upon us the spirit of your love, O Lord, and unite the wills of all who share this heavenly food. The body and blood of Jesus Christ, our Lord, to whom with the Holy Spirit and the Creator be all honor and glory, now and forever. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Tonight we'll have processional communion. There'll be three stations, one in the middle, one on each side. Yet everyone, of course, is welcome to receive Holy Communion. We'll have intinction, take the bread and dip it in the wine, the first chalice, or the juice, the second chalice. Again, all are welcome to receive the Lord's Supper. Let us come as you are ready.
Missed each and every face. Come on and play me one easy. Let's turn on every love light in the place. This time I found myself totally surrounded in your circles. Whoa, my friends, please celebrate me. Give me a number, please. Celebrate me home. Play me one more song that I'll always remember, that I can recall whenever I find myself too all alone. I can send me home. It's an uneasy highway, traveling where the westerly winds can't fly. Somebody tried to tell me, but the man forgot to tell me why. I gotta count on being gone. Come on, mama, come on, daddy, and please, what you want from me? I'll be strong. Number, please, would you celebrate me back home? Play me one more song that I'll always remember, that I can recall whenever I find myself too all alone. I can make believe I've never gone, and I never know where I belong. Send me home, celebrate me home. A number, please, celebrate me home. Play me one more song, yo. Yeah. but I'm not a Rome. Come on, celebrate me home. Please celebrate me home.
Please rise as you're able. Now may the body and precious blood of our Savior and Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you this day unto life everlasting. Let us pray. O God, we give you thanks on this Christmas Eve that you have set before us this feast, the body and blood of your Son. By your Spirit, strengthen us to serve all in need and to give ourselves away for the peace of the world. In Jesus' name, amen. At this time, we're going to light the candles tonight. We'd ask that you be very careful because there's so many people around you, but the acolytes will come to your pew. If you would, when you're getting a light, tip your candle over. Let me get this right. Yes. And then hold it for the next person to tip over and just light all the candles, and then we'll sing Silent Night.
Sat upon your knee, I came to you with childhood fantasies. Well, I'm all grown up now and still need help somehow. I'm not a child, but my heart still can dream. So here's my lifelong wish, my grown-up Christmas list, not for myself, but for a world in need. No more lives torn apart, that wars would never start, and time would heal all hearts. Everyone would have a friend, and right would always win, and love would never. Grown up Christmas list. As children, we believed the grandest sight to see was something lovely wrapped beneath the tree. Well, heaven surely knows that packages and bows could never heal a hurting human soul. No more lives torn apart, that wars would never start, and time would heal all hearts. Everyone would have a friend, and right would all love would never end. Oh, this is my grown-up Christmas list. What is this illusion called? The innocence of youth. Maybe only in our blind belief can we ever find the truth.
Let's join together in silent night and think of the need for silence throughout this creation. Parts of the world, it's already Christmas Day, so turn to your neighbor and say, Merry Christmas. And let us go out with God's blessing and benediction, and may you all have a blessed day tomorrow as we recommit ourselves to carry that light of Christ in us everywhere we go and to greet others as if we're meeting the divine in themselves. May you go forth this Christmas Eve with joy. May you return with peace. May the mountains and the hills burst into song at your coming. May the trees of the field clap their hands. And may the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine upon you and give you justice and peace. The Lord's face look upon you and give you favor in the name of the Creator, the Redeemer, and Spirit. Amen.
Let every heart repair him through. heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven and heaven and nature sing. Joy to the earth, the Savior reigns. Let all their songs employ, while fields and floods, rocks, hills, and plains repeat the sounding joy. Repeat the sounding joy. Repeat, repeat the sounding joy. Verse 3. No more let sin and sorrow grow, nor thorns infest the ground. He comes to make his blessings flow, far as the curse is found, far as the curse is found, far as the curse is found. Verse 4.
Thank you, people of Augustana and friends. Go in peace, rejoice in Christ our Lord the Savior, and thanks be to God. Serve the world.
Mistletoe, I'm gonna get to know you better this Christmas. And as we trim the tree, how much better it's gonna be for us this Christmas. The fireside is blazing bright, and we're caroling all through the night. And this Christmas and cards are here. My heart is filled with cheer, and you this Christmas. And as I look around, your eyes outshine the town. Yes, they do. This Christmas, the fireside is blazing bright, and we'll be caroling all through the night. And this Christmas will be a very special Christmas for you and me. Yeah, 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 yeah. Let's make Christmas special. I'm gonna get to know you better.
we trim the tree, put the lights up and the mistletoe. Here we go, it's Christmas time. Yeah.